We're in a new frontier of Alzheimer's disease research. Historically, we've been relegated to analyzing a few proteins to look at the pathology of Alzheimer's disease. But now we can look at that pathology in conjunction with all of the genomic changes surrounding that pathology.
David Gate studies how neurodegenerative disease changes the immune system. And for Alzheimer's patients, some of these changes are at the genetic level.
And it alters the ability of the immune system to respond to pathogens, to initiate inflammatory responses.
Now he thinks that understanding and targeting these changes could be a route to treating the disease.
Well, I'd always been interested in the immune system and the communication between the brain and the immune system. During my training, I noticed that a lot of the newer genomics tools that were coming onto the scene had not yet been applied to Alzheimer's, and especially the Alzheimer's disease immune system. So that's where I started with Tony Weiss-Garay at Stanford University. We discovered that the cerebral spinal fluid, this is a fluid that flows in your spinal column and in and around your brain, is transcriptionally altered. That means that the genes of your cerebral spinal fluid immune cells change with Alzheimer's disease. This was a rather striking finding to us. There was, at the time, very little known about the cerebral spinal fluid immune system. And we followed this up to study other neurodegenerative diseases with different underlying causes. These diseases are known as Lewy body dementias. And we found that the cerebral spinal fluid immune system is also altered in those patients, but it's altered in a different way. And so this was a very intriguing result to us, which suggested that these different brain diseases, which have different underlying causes, both have immune system changes in the cerebral spinal fluid. And this raises the tantalizing possibility that perhaps we can treat these diseases by mitigating this inflammatory response that we see in the cerebral spinal fluid. This is perhaps a way of modulating the neuroinflammation of Alzheimer's disease that, as we now all know, is the prime component of the disorder.
More recently, David has set up his own lab, where he continues to investigate the links between neurodegenerative disease and the immune system, identifying further connections between the two.
So we're able to analyze the genetic content of single cells and look at the changes that occur among immune cell populations. So in this study, we found that there is an epigenetic modification to a gene called CXCR3. And you can think of this gene as a sort of antenna on the surface of cells that allows them to traffic into the brain.
David's findings suggest that this change increases expression of CXCR3 on T cells, which could encourage more of these cells into the brain, where they might contribute to the abnormal inflammatory response observed in the brains of people with Alzheimer's disease.
And so this might be a target that we can therapeutically modulate to treat Alzheimer's disease.
This research also stratified patients based on which APOE gene they have. APOE is a gene involved in the metabolism of fats and comes in three main subtypes, with APOE4 being linked to an increased risk of Alzheimer's disease.
We discovered that APOE4 carriers have a more inflamed immune system, and we identified the genes that mediate that inflamed immune system in these patients. The immune system of Alzheimer's disease patients is altered at the genetic level. So we believe that targeting the immune system, that reversing these epigenetic changes, or reprogramming these cells that we think are bad into cells that we think could be good for the disease, would be a smart therapeutic strategy to treat Alzheimer's disease.
Next though, David thinks researchers may need to better understand some of the therapies that are already being administered.
So what I'm most interested now is in these new therapeutic drugs for Alzheimer's disease, these anti-amyloid monoclonal antibodies. These are now administered to patients, but we know very little about how they might alter the immune system of these patients. and how that alteration of the immune system might lead to better or worse disease outcomes for these drugs.